Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. We are back on Mass Effect Andromeda, and it is time to take these last 2 points that we need, so let's get into it. So I noticed a couple of things with the recordings. It seems that we may be a touch loud on the audio of voices, as well as the audio of, like, it's not really the combat, it's like just the thruster pack, so I don't really know how I'm going to adjust that audio. Got some containers here, but I'm gonna go for this episode at least with the current modifications, and then I'm only recording once tonight. I gotta get up early tomorrow for work. So
more remnant bots. These ones don't seem hostile.
Okay, well, I totally didn't wait for that to say that, so now they are hostile. My bad.
Reloading.
I see enemies. I shoot. Oh, there's one behind me? Okay, there we go. I am getting better at this game. As I start getting hit by an enemy. There we go, okay. I think I want to push around this way. Just first fire that one down. Alright, we're good. Should have some ammo here. Oh, that's health. Is there ammo?
We're so close. I just know it. Once we get that linguist, we'll crack it.
I detect a high level of remnant encryption here, Pathfinder. To continue, you will need to decrypt it.
Been a slow start, but we got this. Oh no. No!
Decryption impossible due to missing glyph information. Scan nearby surroundings. Okay,
so we need to review
on all bots and maybe blue.
They were saving any data they could, in case it helped the next try.
That's awesome. Allows you to interface directly with remnant consoles to turn various devices on, turn them off, or make them work to your advantage. Glowing power lines indicate active devices. Faded power lines indicate inactive devices. Okay, so that creates more cover. Well, it doesn't matter because we're looking for glyphs. Doesn't well. Is this gonna be like the last one where we just gotta go up on one of those points? I would think so, but there's not any. Oh, what is this? Oh, this remains.
I'll need to use the interface that controls this.
Ah, here we go.
Nice work.
Up onto here. Okay, so here's the glyph. What's this over here? Unknown resonant device. Okay. Before I jump down, anything else up here that I need? Oh, okay, I gotta grab the edge. Doesn't look like it. Let's see if that was enough. No. Okay, we're still missing. Use one remnant decryption key to override this console.
Guess we'll have to scan for the rest of these.
There's another one somewhere around here. Guess let's head back up top and check. Does it look like I can get up on? Scan for glyphs. I need one more glyph. I just noticed that thing on top of the screen. So here, not looking like there's any glyphs on this one. Oh, here we go. Go ahead and interface.
Interface accepted.
Come on. Go. Ah, there we go. Okay. Guess I gotta scan it from a distance.
I detect no additional glyphs in the area.
Alright, back to the console. Let's see what we got now. Okay.
Interface failed, Pathfinder. Defense systems engaging.
Alright, dude. That's not good. Okay.
Got them all.
Okay, well, that's pretty weak. Okay. What did I do wrong here?
Interface failed, Pathfinder. Defense systems engaging.
Okay, let's try this again. Decrypt the remnant code by assigning glyphs to the grid. Or highlighted shape can include repeats of the same glyph.
Interface failed, Pathfinder. Defense systems engaging.
Alright, I'll figure this out. What the heck? Alright, let's try this again. See if I can figure this out.
Interface failed, Pathfinder. Defense systems engaging.
I don't really... I'll get this. Let's see. Okay. Remnant decryption. Decrypt the remnant code by assigning glyphs to the grid. I don't have any... I don't get what it means. Oh! Alright, I see. Highlighted shape. Okay. So is the goal... Okay, so is the goal to have... Okay, no row, column, or highlighted shape can include repeats of the same glyph. Okay, so that's gotta be that, and then this has to be this one. That would make the three, this go there. And so here would be that one. Down here would be this. Down here would be the three again. And then this one would be this. There we go. Okay, I figured that out. All right.
Nice work.
Took a little bit of time to put it all together.
Whatever that did, I see pathways lighting up all over. The monoliths are resonating. QEC contact?
Well, whatever's happening, they're definitely connecting.
You did good. Keep doing more. Can't drop ship.
Seriously? Can't catch a break.
Huh. Well, hold on. I'm not even up there anymore.
Radiation levels within acceptable limits. Life support at 100%.
Ooh, an anointed. We've got a new enemy.
Core is hurt!
Start doing a little scanning here. Oh, there's still one alive. Maybe not. I don't know what's happening. Alright, let's grab all of the supplies here. go grab some ammo that was over here. Where'd my ammo go? Here. No, this isn't the ammo. There it is. There we go. Full ammo. Let's go back to the... to our rover. Get to the next point. Okay, so we need to head in that direction. I don't know if we're gonna be able to take the rover. Well, time to find out. Okay, it can handle falls. Okay. Still a little bit of trial and error going on here. I'm trying to figure out, you know,
we've got targets.
What it'll take and what it won't. Like, it can obviously it can do these jumps, so we know that now. It can't go in water. We figured that out. Anything else I'm wondering with this thing? I guess I figured out that it has its two modes. It has its climbing mode and its speed mode.
Activating automated forward station deployment.
Actually, I don't need to hit that up. Acquire 2 Andromeda viability points. EO's viability increase plus 2%.
That looks like a cat facility of some kind.
Those assholes took over my best research site. They won't let you near the monolith without a fight.
Alright, I think it's time to ditch the vehicle. Let's do this. Alright, pretty simple. Just clear the enemies. Kill the thing right in front of you.
Get incoming!
Wait, is it a dropship coming? Oh, yep, there's the dropship. Man, that guy eats. Alright. Get some cover. I'll let my shields recharge. Take out that chosen. Oh, I'm stuck on something. Let's get down in some cover, recover some health. Hurting on health just a little bit. How did I switch what? That's not how you do it. No, that's not how I do it. How did I do that weapon switch? There was a button that let me weapon switch. Grab the reload. Was it? No, it's not that. It's not B. That's not that. What was it? There was a button that let me switch weapons. Alright, now this is gonna bother me. What button was it? That just... Okay, whatever. There's a button, I'll figure it out. It's not a big deal. It's just annoying you have to go into this to switch weapons. What is this? It's a generator? Okay, so I can't get in there. Oh, here we go, we got another generator up here. Okay, he looks he looked glitched.
Reinforcements. Do they know we're here?
Well, that guy certainly didn't know where we're here, because... Okay, so I can't get into there still. Ah, here we go. Oh, cutscene, I see.
Let's get to it before there's any more cat.
What the hell?
That was pretty cool.
Huh. Well, yeah. Guess it was. Still haven't told me who you are.
I'm the Pathfinder.
Are you now?
You can call me Ryder.
I'm Drak, Clan Nakmore. You'll forgive me if I didn't just trust a stranger from the Nexus. They haven't exactly treated us Krogan well. What are you doing out here?
Checking out these monoliths? The cats seem pretty interested in this one. Looks like you cleared it out for us, though.
You said I didn't save any for you? Nexus knows shit about the cat. They think they're safe. But they're just waiting to die out there in space. I've been quads deep on a couple of planets for a while now, taking out Ket bases, fighting ground troops. Ugh, I know what they can do.
It's not pretty.
You know, we could use a Krogan like you, Drak.
I'm flattered, but do you have any idea how many humans I've watched die? Your meat is spoiled. Besides, the day I help the Nexus again is the day the clouds part and the Ket keel over. No offense.
None taken.
Good, because I'm getting bored and the Ket are getting stronger. Seem particularly interested in this alien tech.
Remnant?
Yeah, that. I'm gonna go find more to shoot. Try to keep your head out there.
He seems fun.
I kinda like him. Off the door. Okay, so that leads back to there. I would not assume the glyphs are in here, but I do want to look around.
This component was security tagged for Site 2.
Looks like they had some sort of special project going. Let's find the rest.
Assuming this just opens to the other side, yes it does. Alright, let's go find these glyphs to scan. I'm assuming eventually he'll become a character that can join our party. Okay, let's see. Glyphs. Ah, here we go. Can I just jump that? Thank you. There we go. No glyph on here. Oh, there we go. Okay, there's one glyph. No glyph here. Okay, where would another glyph be? Trying to look for areas that would allow us to jump up. Ah, there's a question mark on my map. Ah, here we go. Believe I found the second glyph.
That should do it.
Alright. Time to solve another puzzle. Oh no, we don't even have to solve a puzzle on this one.
You good at this?
Done. The monoliths are online and connected to something in the lake? This could be the master switch we're looking for.
I'll meet you there. Don't do anything without me.
Alright, let's go grab our vehicle and head to the lake. I'm interested for the first, like, boss, boss fight or major fight. Because right now we've just been destroying Ket. We haven't actually fought something formidable yet. I thought that was going to be our first formidable enemy, but turned out to be friendly, so.
Radiation levels have spiked, Pathfinder.
I think this is the quickest way to get around is to jump. Alright, down the cliff we go. Go on, change modes. Should be over there in no time. Bring it over here. Hop on out. Alright. Wonder if we as a playable character can swim. I don't really want to test it at this moment, but okay, so we got some Vandium.
Look there. Coming out of the lake.
The tech's underground too? Let's see.
It's opening up.
I see a door. Come on!
Oh, it's forming a bridge.
Let's find out how solid it is.
The fact that the bridge forms like that makes me believe that you cannot swim in the water.
Radiation levels within acceptable limit.
Wait.
No, this can't be right. All that fanfare for an empty room? There's some secret here. There must be. Do your Pathfinder thing. Oh, you're good.
And I make it look so easy.
How far down do you think it goes?
Only one way to find out.
That can't be air pressure. Electrostatic? gravitation. Oh, you idiot, PB. That wasn't the front door. This is.
I'll let you know.
Hey!
Well, there's no way I'm dying, so might as well. I kind of wish one of us would have stayed up top. I wonder what happens if I don't jump. You gotta go down here.
It's acting like a gravity well.
But where's it taking us?
Embrace the unknown, Ryder. Now this is more like...
Looks like a bunker. Or a vault.
Whatever you call it. The controls for that atmosphere processor might be down here somewhere.
Let's find out.
Anything could be important. Let's be thorough.
Alright, I think that'll do it for this episode, guys. I think this is a good stopping point. In the next one, we will go ahead and give down here a nice look. Before I end the episode...
Then we have a way out.
You're not leaving already, are you?
Not until we find those processor controls.
Alright, before we head out, we've got some skills to upgrade. Let's go ahead and do Cora first. She's got 6 skill points, so we can get Charge, Nova, Shield Boost, Asari Commando. Okay, let's go ahead and grab this first. Let's grab 2 into those. Ooh, what's Regeneration? Alright, let's grab the 3 abilities into that first here. Combat, or Defensive Training. Confirm those skill points. Alright, Liam. I think I'm just gonna throw 2 into his both of those that we were working on. And now for myself. I've got 7 points to go into combat, biotics, and tech. Nova. Channels energy into a point-blank high-damage explosion around the user. Man, there are a lot of choices. Combat fitness. I kind of want to do this. Oh, I have to have 9 skill points invested into this. Okay, that makes this less... Assault turret deploys an automated assault turret that counts as a tech construct, directs the turret to attack a particular target, hold button detonates the turret, damaging nearby enemies, cryo beam, tactical cloak. Alright, I think the assault turret. That sounds interesting. Let's go ahead and get that. Go ahead and upgrade it a little bit. Go ahead and assign the power. Actually, I don't know what's the difference. And let me throw one into... Oh, I can't throw it into the tactical cloak yet. I'm gonna grab this and have multiple powers available. Okay, I think that's good. Infiltrator unlocked. Alright. Okay, so now LB and RB does that.
I've got your
LB does that.
Look there.
RB throws out the turret.
It's like a broken information display.
Alright, that works. Okay. Now that I've got those abilities and skill points spent, I think it's time to call it an episode.
Maybe they can't get into the vault.
But you can. That'll get their attention.
Lucky me.
So, in the next episode, we'll take on this vault and see what it has to offer, but I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you all then. Peace out!